We are the Pharaohs Rover team, and this is our place at which we share our knowledge and prepare for the University Rover Challenge 2020. Our team is split into three main groups: electrical group, mechanical group, and science group. The rover's chassis is made of carbon fiber rods assembled with screws, allowing for easy assembly and disassembly for shipping. It has three different configuration sets: a double wishbone suspension configuration, either 6x6 or 4x4, and an Ackerman steering configuration, giving us the ability to switch between different configurations according to the mission requirements. The suspension system is calculated by doing a mathematical model for the system to calculate required stiffness and fixation of springs. Motion study is done on the new system to test its ability to traverse hard and inclined terrain and carry the required load. We are currently in the manufacturing phase and are practicing on an old system to gain driving experience and train new members. A 6-degree of freedom robotic arm was designed with a maximum payload of 5 kg and a nearly spherical workspace. It consists of three cascaded 2-degree of freedom joints, each implemented using a differential bevel gear set. The first two joints are self-locked by worm gear reduction stage at each motor to assure fail-safe operation, while timing belts are used for the last joint. The structure was made of 3mm aluminum trusses to maximize the strength-to-weight ratio. The control system consists of multiple interconnected subsystems that achieve high integrity and reliability. Rover main controller consists of two redundant modules and supports multiple interfaces to enhance reliability, and provides two PID controllers on both linear and angular velocity. We developed our custom DC smart drivers that provide PID control on both angular velocity and position, with feedback of angle, angular velocity, power, temperature, and estimated torque. We also designed our custom robotic arm controller for easy manipulation. The rover is powered by 22 amp hour LiPo batteries, which are monitored by the main controller. Emergency power switches were added for safety. The external communication is based on 2.4 GHz Wi-Fi and 900 MHz RF, along with 5.8 GHz RFD video link, while internal communication consists of Ethernet, serial, UART, RS-485, and USB connections. We implemented a video server which concatenates multiple video transmissions into a single video, resulting in a fixed data rate. It supports up to 6 cameras with a bitrate of 5 megabits per second, and allows for zooming without losing quality. We are currently testing the rover's capabilities to achieve the competition test. We have trained to minimize setup time, achieving a time of less than 3 minutes. For the extreme retrieval task, we have built a field to test our rover on rough terrain and steep inclines. In order to test our arm, we have built a panel similar to the URC panel. For the autonomous task, localization is done through sensor fusion between LiDAR, GPS, IMU, and stereo vision using extended Kalman filter. The rover is then visualized on Google Maps using GPS sensor to ensure the rover maintains its path. AR detection is implemented using the convolution neural network. The science box was designed with the ability of testing up to 4 different samples. It was designed specifically to fulfill the no-spill policy. These samples are collected using our specially designed shovel, providing more control over sample collection. Chemical indicators such as iodine, burette, and emulsion are used to detect the presence of life in a given sample, in which they have a rapid response and are easily detected. Machine learning, specifically the convolution neural network, is being used to identify different types of rocks by comparing with a database of rock samples. 11 sensors are being used to measure changes in different gases to see if there is any sign of life in the surrounding environment.